Hey guys, Ellison Barber here in Miami, Florida. Again, we're soon, in the next hour or so, we're going to hear former President Barack Obama speak. He will be up on that stage, certainly encouraging people here to get out and to vote and vote early. This is the first time President Obama has come to the state to campaign on behalf of his former vice president. He's coming at a critical time because early voting started in Florida this week. This is the first weekend of early voting. I want to show you back over. You can see all these cars, just a sea of cars. This is, of course, it's COVID-19. This is a drive-in rally, and he will be speaking to the audience here. You've heard them honking. You see their flags. They are excited. Some of them started arriving here at about 8 a.m. The hope for Democrats in Florida is that President Obama's presence here will help energize the Democratic base and make sure that they turn out and turn out in droves.
Hey guys, we're here in Circleville, Ohio, where President Trump will be holding a rally in a couple of hours. The president putting a really keen focus on Ohio. The vice president was here yesterday. This is a state that President Trump won by about 8.5 points last time against Hillary Clinton. But here in Pickaway County, outside of Columbus, he won by more than 30 points last time around. And so the president, as you can see, is coming to an area that his base is really active. He's no longer trying to compete as much in the swing areas of Ohio in the big cities, but instead trying to ramp up turnout as high as he can in the areas where he still has a strong base of support. Senator Kamala Harris is also in Ohio today. She's in Cleveland, about 2.5 hours north of here, as all of the candidates try to win over Ohio and its 19 electoral votes. For President Trump, a really critical state to win. No Republican has won the White House without winning Ohio.
Is there someone over at the back riser that could, like, take our picture? Yeah.